Hello everyone, and welcome to this very final lecture on vibrations of beams. In this lecture, I will discuss the forced vibration response of beams. So basically, we are going to look for the response of the beam when it is subjected to external loads. For that, we are going to require the equation of motion, where the right-hand side now contains this distributed load. We also have boundary conditions and initial conditions again. In general, the response of the system can be written in terms of its homogeneous solution and its particular solution. And only as soon as we have the combination, we will apply the initial conditions to determine the still the unknown coefficients in the homogeneous response. But if we are interested in only steady state behavior, most of the time we only solve the particular solution, and for that we will not need the initial conditions, and only the external force will suffice. So let's start off by writing down again the modal expansion. Which basically says that the solution of V of X can be written in terms of its infinite modes, Vn function of X, eta n function of t, only the modal coordinates. So you see that this procedure only makes sense as soon as you already have determined the natural modes, so that must be done first. Once you have them, you mass normalize them and you substitute it into the equation of motion to obtain sum of, let me use I now, I is 1 to infinity, rho A VI eta I double dot plus the infinite sum of EI times VI fourth derivative times eta I itself, and this is equal to the right hand side f. Now we multiply the entire equation by vj and we integrate to obtain I is 1 to infinity rho a integral vj vi dx eta I double dot plus the infinite sum of ei times the integral of Vj times Vi 1, 2, 3, 4 dx eta I itself, and here we then have the integral of Vj times f dx. So by applying the orthogonality conditions, these integrals become extremely simple. All terms are zero except for the term where I is equal to 1. So only we need to consider the case that I is equal to j. We only need to consider this case and obtain that eta I double dot plus omega I squared times eta I itself is equal to qi, where qi is only a function of time and equals the integral of vi times f dx. And this is then called the modal force. So these are the modal equations. Modal equations. And this is the expression for the modal force. So in fact, we define Qi like this. Modal force. Where I is 1, 2, and so on. So the strategy here is that we solve the modal equations for eta I as a function of time using Estoff techniques. So is solved using Estoff techniques. So once you know what kind of external force acts on the system, you compute the modal force. Then you solve for eta I, and once you know what eta I is, you back substitute that into the modal expansion to determine the total solution. So typically what you see in this procedure is that the most complicated part is actually computing the integral that is in the modal force. Once you have established the modal force, I would say the rest is relatively straightforward. Now, doing an example would already be quite a lot of work, and I think by the examples we've done before, that you have quite a good idea of how to deal with that. So I think this is everything that I wanted to tell you about doing a forced vibration response on beams. That concludes this this lecture already. I think there were quite some lectures on beams. I would say in general very similar to strings, bar, shafts, but the fact that the equation of motion was different, in my opinion, made it interesting to look at it in a bit more detail as well. I thank you very much for watching, and take care.